have already done with asexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction is the reproduction in which single parent is involved and produced offsprings are genetically as well as morphologically cloned to each other. What is clone? Clone means similar. Let's deal with the sexual reproduction. We know that sexual reproduction is the reproduction in which two gametes are involved, that is male and female. Sexual reproduction involves the formation of male and female gametes in either the same individuals or two individuals. Sexual reproduction is the production of new living organisms by combining male and female gametes. By combining male and female gametes in either the same individual or the two different individuals, sexual reproduction is formed. We know that male gametes and female gametes are produced by the male and female. These gametes fuse to form a zygote, which develops into a new individual. Okay, we know that male produces male gamete, whereas female produces female gamete. This male and female gamete fuse to form a zygote. Offspring are not identical to each other or to their parents. In sexual reproduction, we find that offspring are not identical to each other. What is identical? Identical means clone. Are not identical to each other. I have told you the meaning of clone in asexual reproduction. Clone refers to same or identical. We have learned that asexually reproducing organisms are genetically and morphologically cloned to each other. But in the case of sexual reproduction, this does not take place. They are not cloned to each other and to their parents. Clone means identical. Sexually reproducing organisms are not cloned to each other because they produces variations. Variation, what is variation? Variations refers to the difference between the parents and the progeny. Okay. Offsprings are not identical to each other and to their parents. So sexually reproducing organisms give rise to diversity among living organisms. So they are not identical to each other and to their parents. This leads to the differences between them. That is a diversity among living organisms. All sexually reproducing organisms share a similar pattern of reproduction. Sexual reproduction gives rise to diversity among the living organisms. And they also share the similar pattern of reproduction. Organism pass through two stages. Each and every organism pass through two important stages. Which are those? They are juvenile phase and vegetative phase. Sexually reproducing organism pass through different stages, that is juvenile phase and vegetative phase. So what is juvenile phase? Juvenile phase, the period of growth of an individual organism after its birth before it reaches to reproductive maturity. Period of growth from birth to reproductive maturity is called as juvenile phase. Okay, in the simple and short, the period after the birth and before its reaching maturity is called as juvenile phase. Now, what is vegetative phase or reproductive phase? The period when an individual organism reproduces sexually is called as reproductive phase. The period when an individual organism starts reproducing sexually is called as vegetative phase or reproductive phase. In non-primate animal mammals like rats, sheep, dogs, cows and tigers, the cyclic changes in the activities of the ovaries and the oviduct is called as oestrus cycle. In primates like monkeys, apes and humans is called as menstrual cycle. We are familiar with the words called primates and non-primate mammals. We human beings are primates. Even monkeys, apes are primates. The non-primate mammals are rats, sheep, dogs, cows, tigers, etc. There are two important cycles taking place in the organs. They are organisms, that is oestrus cycle and menstrual cycle are the two important cycles taking place. Okay, first, what is oestrus cycle? The cyclic changes in the activities of ovaries and oviduct is called as oestrus cycle. Now, what is menstrual cycle? menstrual cycle is the regular and natural change that occurs in the female reproductive system is called as menstrual cycle. It is a regular cyclic process which takes place in only in the females. In female monkeys, apes and humans are some of the examples. Okay. Now, certain mammals are called continuous breeders and certain are called as seasonal breeders. What are continuous breeders? They can reproduce throughout their reproductive phase. The organisms which can reproduce throughout the reproductive phase, there is no gap for them. They can reproduce every time, anytime. They are called as continuous breeders. Whereas seasonal breeders, they can reproduce only in the favorable seasons. Seasonal breeders can reproduce only in the favorable, important seasons. Okay, whereas continuous breeders can reproduce throughout their reproductive. Of continuous breeders is rabbit and cattle. Rabbit and cattle are some example which can reproduce throughout their reproductive phase. First of all, examples for seasonal breeders is frog and lizard. Frog and lizard are the organisms which reproduce only in the favorable seasons.